I'm going to Steve Houston, and guess what? I didn't mean to date the video, but it is Christmas time. Have my Santa Claus hat on, and just want to say to all of you, if you're traveling over the holidays, be safe, enjoy the family, whatever you're celebrating this time of the year. It's all about being around family and friends and enjoying that time together. So be safe in your travels while you do it and take that time off for rest and relaxation. This week, I want to just kind of break it down. By the way, if you're seeing me for the first time, welcome to the channel. On this channel, if you don't already know it, since you're brand new and never been here before, we talk about all things regarding the financial services industry. We talk about mortgage protection and final expense. We talk about the IMOs. We compare the IMOs. We compare the comp plans. We talk about the products. We dive deep into some sales training and how to sell this stuff. On this channel, we do two uploads a week. We just changed it. We're doing it now on Tuesdays and on Fridays, so you have time over the weekend to review the information and materials. Love to have your comments. Again, if you're not a subscriber, mash the subscribe button, hit the bell down below. Do me a favor, like and comment and share the video out. I would be grateful, and I do try to respond to every single comment that's on the channel. This week, I want to give a disclaimer. I just got back from a couple of appointments, wrote a couple of apps this evening. It's just before we break for the holidays, and it was important to me and to the clients to get out there and see them before we entered into that time where we're very, very busy with family obligations and parties and all that kind of stuff. And I was on the road for a couple of hours talking to some agents, and I want to kind of put this disclaimer out there. Because maybe I haven't talked about it enough. I'm not sure I've ever have talked about it. Maybe I just assumed it. But these opinions on these videos are mine. They are generated over years in this industry, me making bad decisions and figuring it out later and then sharing those with you through this channel, seeing things really as they really are once you're in an IMO. Actually, are sometimes quite different because this industry is so much about recruit. Don't get those things out of order. Some will, some won't, so what? All that network marketing, we have a lot of that in this industry. And because of that, many of us get stuck with places we don't want to be after the onion gets peeled back a little bit. And I'm trying to share those things through these videos with you. Now, there's differences of opinion. It's my opinion because it's been my experience. You may find it to be different, and certainly if a recruiter is telling you that I don't know what I'm talking about, there's a reason potentially why they're telling you that, right? But whatever the truth is about these IMOs and about these products in this industry, these are the truths that I have decided to share with you through these channels. Again, you don't have to agree with them. As I said, they are mine, and I'm open for comments that you can leave below as long as they're positive comments. Everybody has a difference of opinion, right? And it pains me sometimes to see people come back to me later and say, hey, this guy over here with some ridiculous IMO that no one's ever heard of is going to offer me these big contracts, and they have these great leads, and I want to make more money. Well, let me just say something right up front here. High contracts don't equal high commissions, and I'm going to get into that. Look, high contracts are the biggest head fake in the industry, right? There's always a reason why those high contracts are there. Think about it for a second. Look, you get what you pay for, generally speaking, in this country. And I don't want to get too far into this, but look, my goal with these videos is to tell you the truth as I see it from what I've experienced or been told by not just a couple of agents, by many agents, on the IMOs that they're in. If I haven't been there, I've done my research on the IMO itself, on the executives, the compensation plan, the management team, and so on. Many of them I did experience firsthand, right? And that's why I have such strong opinions about them. Or like I said, I have done my due diligence and I've researched their comp plans. I've poked holes in it. I've found the places where it doesn't really benefit you, the agent. And some of them, like I said, I've looked at all this stuff and some of it I've witnessed with my eyes wide open, what's really happening in this industry. And that's what I'm sharing here. And I challenge all of you to go ask these questions. Go ask them if your income is capped if you don't recruit. But don't just take their word for it. Make them produce the documents that shows that you can go to the top of the contract without a recruiting requirement. Don't just ask them. Because look, they have a financial interest in not being completely forthright with you. That's the whole point, right? So do your research. Watch these videos. Jot down the questions. I'm always available to have conversations with you on text, email, or on my phone. That information is down below in my description information, right? So I just kind of wanted to share that with you today. I also wanted to announce that we are changing the upload schedule. We're going to be uploading on Tuesdays and on Fridays. On Tuesdays and Fridays, the reason why is it gets to be a challenge on the weekend to do an upload on Sundays, because then I spend most of the weekend doing the editing and not with my family. So Tuesdays and Fridays seems to work out the best. I hope you join me and watch those videos on those days. And again, like I said, if you're not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button. If you know other people in the industry that may be interested in this kind of information, share the videos out to them, and maybe we can hit that 1,000 subscriber goal before the end of the year. We're about 70 subscribers away, and we can do it if we share it enough and get it out there, put it on your Facebook page, whatever you want to do. I'd be grateful for that. Not required. I'm asking, right? Leave a comment and like the videos. As always, it helps that video get out there to other agents that may be searching. And that's the goal, is maybe I can share some information. I do appreciate, again, people that call me. I had two great conversations today. People said that, look, see, I appreciate the fact that you're pretty transparent. You tell it like it is, and no fluff, smoke, and mirrors. It just is what it is. And that's my goal, not to offend anybody, but to tell you, here's what the facts are. Go prove me wrong. Make them provide documentation to prove it otherwise. But I can tell you that most of these IMOs, these network marketing types, there is a recruiting requirement in order for you to advance to the high contracts, right? And if they're starting you out at a high contract right away and you're a completely new, inexperienced agent, you're going to pay a price for that. Somewhere along the line, I can tell you a few of them out there that if you ask them what their availability is for leads, you might get a straight answer, but most of them have no mortgage station leads, only final expense, and that's a different game entirely. If you want to work just final expense, go do it, but do your research, right? But again, you need to be specific on asking them those questions and have them provide documentation. Again, a high contract, no leads, or a high contract, only working final expense, which is a lower value sale, you're going to make less money, it's more of a lower income sale, is not necessarily a good place to be. High contract doesn't mean high commissions. Contract rate doesn't mean commission rate. If you're writing their core products, the contract rate should equate to the commission rate. But if you go off and write, for example, this industry, as I said before, is really driven on the non-med. The leads are generated that way. Non-med meaning no exam. The leads are generated that way. And if you are selling non-med, no exam products, your contract rate that you are offered should equal the commission rate, right? Minus the 25%. But if you're moving outside of the non-med or no exam products, your commission is going to vary depending on the product and the carrier. So just understand that. If you're getting offered 100% contract, don't expect 100% commission. You'll get 100% of the percentage paid on that product. Okay, let me give you an example. If you're selling, like, to say, for example, mutual term life answers, your IMO may be paying only 50% for that product. I'm not saying ours does. I'm saying that's possible with certain IMOs. Some IMOs are going to be less. So if you're getting paid 50% on that particular product, let's just say it's $1,000 worth of APV, your commission is going to be $500 less the 25%, right? Now, if you're selling 1,000 APV with a non-med product, and that's their core product, and you're at 1,000 APV, and you're at a 70% contract, you should get paid 70% of that APV value minus the 25% that they hold back in the event of chargebacks. Now, I had that question come up today, actually, regarding chargeback. Well, Steve, I thought you told me there wasn't any chargeback because they're holding back the 25%. Well, again, the 25% is really building up a savings account to be able to pay your chargebacks from. It doesn't mean that the other 75% is non-chargebackable. It is, if it chargebacks within the 9-month time frame. Remember, you're getting 9 months advanced commission. If the policy cancels in 6 months, you're gonna owe 3 months back. Now, everybody gets hung up on this whole chargeback thing. Maybe that's what I should have titled the video, is chargeback, so what? Look, if you're writing good business and you're doing enough volume, the chargeback should never hurt you, right? you should be doing, really, in my opinion, the chargebacks become an issue starts with the presentation in the home, the like, know, and trust you're building with the client. If they like you, you've inoculated them against other agents coming in behind you. I've talked about this before. If you're selling non-med, you need to be very clear with them why they're buying non-med, so that the guy that comes behind you, a guy or gal come behind you, that doesn't that offers them fully underwritten, which will obviously be less money, it just is, right, isn't replacing your products. So I think all that starts in the home. But chargebacks have been around this business forever. If you don't want chargebacks, don't take unearned commissions. Unearned meaning you're getting paid 9 months advanced commission. Advanced means you're getting paid in advance of earning it, right? You can avoid that by going on an as earned, but I'm telling you, it's not that big a deal if you understand that that really begins and ends in the home, the relationship you're building. Now, you can't avoid chargebacks completely. I get them, but I don't get that many, right? It's, again, it goes back to the law of large numbers. As long as you're doing enough activity, your reserve account, that 25% is building up, should be more enough to cover any chargebacks that you have coming in. What happens to many is they don't do enough activity. They've got one or two policies they've written in the last several months, and one cancels, and they've spent the money, and now they're in a tizzy, and that happens. Again, you protect yourself in this business from that happening by doing volume. And I don't mean you got to be a rock star, but you got to be doing business on a regular basis, right? But just expect it that you are, again, you earn the commission when they make the payment. So when you sell them a policy and the carrier takes that first draft, you've earned 1 month's commission. But the carriers will find it very hard to find agents like you and I to drive 2 hours to go meet with a family, so that when they make an $80 premium, you're getting 50% of that, so you made $40. They're not going to find a whole lot of agents willing to do that. So what they do is they come up with this advanced commission. They are willing to pay you 1 year advance commission. They're going to hold back 3 months, right? And they'll pay you 9 months in advance. Once it goes past the 9 months, they'll pay you on months 10, 11, and 12 monthly as that customer makes their payments. That's why you can make so much money in this business up front. At $40, $50 a pop, you'd have to sell a lot of product. And that's why the industry came up with advanced commissions. So understand, as long as you go into this thing with your eyes wide open, those are not surprises. In my opinion, focusing on chargebacks is great, so you can avoid them. But to focus on them or be discouraged by them, you're drowning in the shallow end of the pool. It just is what it is. And there are people making a lot of multiple six figures that have the same chargebacks you and I have. They don't worry about it. They know out of X amount of policies that they sell, they're going to lose a certain percentage of them every year, right? Ours is about 88% that we write stay in the books past 1 year. So that means we know 12 out of 100 will fall off the books the first year. No big deal, right? No big deal. We understand it. Numbers empower you if you understand the numbers. That's why I spend so much time on this channel talking about the numbers, all right? So I hope that helps. Just a short video. We have a special one coming out on the 25th of December, 2018. So if the video is dated because I put those out there, so be it. I apologize. But remember, as I close every video, the surest way not to fail is to be determined to succeed. Thank you very much. I love that statement. As you can tell, I get passionate about it when I say it, because that's everything. If you're willing to adopt that motto, you cannot fail, because you just said to yourself, you're determined to succeed. Then that means quitting is not an option. Take that attitude into 2019 and let's go forward together. I'm always here to help you, regardless of whether or not we're working together. But if you don't have a coach or a mentor that's actually leading from the front, that's out there in the field, putting their name on an application, and you're looking for that type of relationship, give me a call and let's talk about it and see if we're a fit to work together. Have a great day and enjoy the holidays, and Merry Christmas. Bye-bye.